This parsha is Truma. Class is in memory of Jared Orchin. And in Truma, we see something very interesting. It's written when God told Moses to build a temple, he told him to build a temple. And at the beginning, it's God told them, you should build it as I show it to you. In the beginning of the, when he started to tell them that. And when he ended by the telling him what to do, tells them you should build it as is you were shown and it on the mountain. From this the rabbis learn that Moses saw a vision of the old temple. He needed to know what are you talking about? How it's supposed to look like? That God showed them a vision from fire or from other things. He showed them a vision and he saw how the temple looked, that he should be able to build it. Direction is all nice and fine. You need a picture. Then comes to the menorah. The Torah says, you should do it. Ze ma'aseh ha-menorah. This is the how you should make the temple. Well, you should make the menorah. You say this, means you point with a finger. This is how you should do it. You've shown us something. The Rashi says, and the Talmud speaks a lot about it, that Moses had a very hard time in making the menorah. Because it's so many details. Because the menorah is to be made from one piece of gold. Etched out. You cannot attach pieces. You cannot make branches and attach it to the base. You have to take one piece of gold and etch out the menorah from this piece of gold and making the flowers and the cups and the spheres, I think it's called. Three types of decoration on every branch. And the base had to be in a very special way. All of this was very hard. That Moses had a very hard time how to make the menorah. That God showed them a menorah made out of fire. And you know fire has different colors? God showed them, the Rebbe says, in different colors, that the flowers were in one color, and the Kabbalah speaks about it, there is a black color of black fire, there is a green fire, or blue, whatever you call it, in a red fire, different colors of fire. He showed them, the Rebbe said, like, you know, when you walk on electricity, and there is many wires, they do different colors, so people shouldn't be confused. God showed them the menorah in different colors of fire. He should be able to relate and to see which color to do, how to make the flowers and how to make the cups and how to make the branches and so on. But you know what? In the end, it didn't help. It's written in the text, Te'aseh ha-menorah. The menorah was made by itself. God told them in the end, Moses couldn't make it. He just couldn't do it. God told him, take a piece of gold, throw it into the fire, and it came out a menorah.
Like the golden calf.
That's what happened. Then the question is, what was so hard about making the menorah? You know, later in history, when King Solomon built the first temple, you know he built 10 menorahs? You know that? It's in the Book of Kings. It's in two places in the Bible. He built 10 menorahs. Just like, exactly like the menorah that was in the temple. That if King Solomon could build a menorah, could Moses not build a menorah? What's so complicated? That's, the Rebbe is asking this question. The Rebbe says a few answers. Number one, he says, he cannot compare. Solomon had a menorah to look from. He had a menorah for Moses. He copied Moses' menorah. It's a whole different story. Moses did not have a menorah to look at. What is he looking at? He looks at nothing. But more than that, the Rebbe says, Solomon, where was Moses? In the middle of the desert. So he had gold, but he had all this machinery that needed to create such a menorah. He had all the tools. Solomon was a huge, an amazing king, a powerful king. He had people from all over the world, professionals, as many as he wanted. He bought the wood from Lebanon and stuff from all over the world. For him to build a menorah, it's nothing. You cannot compare it. That's why, for for it was easy for Solomon, but not so easy for Moses. But still, there was another piece of furniture that was very hard to make, similar to the menorah in the temple. What was it? Also from gold. Also etched out from one piece.
The ark.
The cherubs.
The cherubs. Yeah. The cover of the ark was a cover, and on top of the cover was the cherubs. Now the cover and the cherubs have to be made out from one, etched out from one piece of gold. To make two cherubs with faces, with all with the wings, with the whole thing from one piece together, is not so easy either. Then why was it so hard? Why is the menorah was so much more difficult than the cherubs? Why the cherubs Moses was able to make, and it came to the menorah, I couldn't do it. Maybe there is something else. No, the whole purpose of the temple. What was the purpose of the temple? Why God said to build a temple? There is a few opinions. But the bottom line, according to Rashi and many other opinions, the temple was an atonement for the golden calf. Because the Jewish people made a golden calf, then God, Moses was the breaking of the tablets. Then by Yom Kippur, when he came down with the second set of tablets, the next day Moses called the Jewish people and told them, God gave you a way to atone for the golden calf. Build a temple from gold, just as you gave gold for the golden calf. So too, you should make gold for the temple. Then because the temple was an atonement for the golden calf, in an atonement, there is a concept that's called, it has to be Tshuvat HaMishkal. The tshuva has to be on the same thing the way it was the sin. The example that the Talmud says, if a person was stealing, how he know he's really will not steal anymore, he's in the same place. And it's the same opportunity. Nobody watches him. And he doesn't steal. We know he really changed. Somebody who has an alcohol problem, addiction. If he's in the same front of the same bottle, and nobody is there, and he doesn't do it. He really cured himself. As he mentioned, in the golden calf, when Aaron tells Moses the story, Moses asks Aaron, what you did to the Jewish people, golden calf? How did this happen? He says, they came to me. They said, they want to. Moses is gone. We need a god. I told them, bring me the gold. He says, I took the gold. I threw it into the fire. Came out a golden calf. Just like this. Ashlicheu ba'esh, v'yetzei ha'egel hazeh. I put them on fire. Maybe to atone, because the whole temple was an atonement for the golden calf, needed to be at least one piece of furniture, one thing that wasn't the same way. It's interesting because the Medrash said, the Jerusalem Talmud says that it was the kaporet, the cherubs were the atonement, the gold of the cherubs was an atonement for the golden calf. But could be the menorah is also an atonement for the golden calf. And just as the golden calf was thrown into the furnace and into the fire and came out ready, so too the menorah. Here Aaron threw it into the fire and came out a golden calf. Here Moses threw it into the fire and came out the menorah. And what's the purpose of the menorah? Why is the Jewish people, the symbol of the Jewish people came the menorah? Not the cherubs, not the Ark of the Covenant, not the altar, not the table, nothing. Because the menorah represents illuminating the world, bringing the light of God to the world, teaching the world that there is no golden calf. There is no other gods. There is no idols. That's what Judaism brought to the world, the monotheistic beliefs, and believing in God. That there is, that's idea that we have to believe in one God. That's the message of the Jewish people. And maybe that's why the menorah was done just like the golden calf, the opposite. Just exactly like in the bad side, so too on the good side, in a way to atone completely for the sin of the golden calf.